Arun Jaitley, this isn't a loss of focus on the part of the Congress. It could be a well-crafted strategy to counter your own Modi-centric campaign. The Congress campaign slogan is "Main Nahi Hum." Main Nahi Hum. And Sonia Gandhi in her speech countered the BJP by calling on voters to vote for a party that believes in institutions and not an individual. Sonia's appeal in the televised address is consistent with the Congress campaign slogan. How does it reflect a loss of focus?
Well, I can't make out. It is confusion most confounded. Since when have political leaders started paying for their own telecast? Any Sonia Gandhi interview or speech would normally be covered live. Any Narendra Modi speech would normally be covered live. An interview would be covered live. I think it's a self-deception where you feel that if you pay for it, it's going to get you votes. This doesn't help. So far, the message has been that the command is in the hands of Rahul Gandhi, and Rahul Gandhi is going to lead you, and the projection has been in that direction. And suddenly some advisors come and tell you, well, it's a paid advertisement by the lady rather than the son herself.
No, why are you
all the difference?
Why are you, Mr.?
I think it's a Tweedledee Tweedlesome difference, which is not going to make
any
impact.
What is the harm if the Congress president makes an appeal? It's consistent with the Main Nahi Hum campaign slogan. She's the leader of the party, and by appearing in a televised address, she's only projecting the idea of a collective leadership.
No, it doesn't make any difference, even whether it's paid or not. Whether it's paid or not, it doesn't make any difference. It is as good as a campaign statement which is made to the country. Now, it's being made every day in the course of speeches. So how does one additional speech make a difference?
No, Mr. Jaitley, instead of worrying over who's taken a backseat, shouldn't the BJP be countering the Congress on the issues Sonia raises in this 3-minute TV attack? The Congress has clearly made this a battle of ideologies, appropriated the BJP stance on strong nationalism as its own. Moreover, Mr. Jaitley, it's blunting your own Modi-centric campaign of Main Desh Nahi Mitne Dunga, with the Congress warning voters of Bharatiyata being ruined if the BJP comes to power.
Well, let me tell you, it's not for the first time the Congress has said this. The emphasis from the very beginning has been on a campaign of this kind, and it hasn't worked. The issue of concern for the people has not been Bharatiyata or Hindustaniyat as the Congress party sees it. Is corruption a part of Hindustaniyat? Is price rise or mismanagement of the economy a part of Bharatiyata? Is corruption a part of, is national security being slackened a part of any form of Bharatiyata? Now, to ignore the real issues before the people, is dilution of the office of the Prime Minister during the UPA a part of Hindustaniyat? Now, that's the issues which are mattering before the people. The issues are of governance. And therefore, to sidestep the issues of governance is not going to help the Congress.
No, but Mr. Jaitley, while you call Sonia's appeal an act of desperation, why don't you believe that this might be a clever strategy to upstage the BJP? Because the word Bharatiyata, interestingly, politically deployed by both Advani and Vajpayee, they said they preferred the word over the word Hindutva. Bharatiyata over Hindutva in 2004. So Sonia Gandhi has in effect made a Congress slogan out of that and charged you with trying to destroy it. So in what you call an act of desperation, Sonia Gandhi is countering the BJP on its own stated principles.
Well, how do you counter it by using the same terminology that we have used? You see, every election has its own agenda. The agenda of this election is not what she's speaking about. The agenda of this election is governance issues and what has happened in the last 10 years. Now, one statement by Mrs. Sonia Gandhi can't deflect from that agenda.
No, but you have used the expression, "Main Nahi Mom." Are you trying to trivialize the issue that both Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi contesting the elections of 2014? I mean, what is the relevance of "Main Nahi Mom"?
Not at all. You see, so far, it's been the young man in front all throughout. Every advertisement carried his photograph. The emphasis was not on the mother, it was not on the Prime Minister, it was on the young man himself. And suddenly you think the young man doesn't work, let the mother work. Therefore, it's a logical, legitimate comment.
But
this is what you people have been discussing on your channels itself.
No, fine. Main Nahi Mom is, you put that catchy word there. But hasn't the BJP also changed its track? You started the elections on a slogan of governance and development. Now we are hearing about polarization, communal speeches, main nahi mom.
You see, it's the Congress which is trying to deflect the agenda and taking into the side lanes by inviting all kinds of people and some parties like the Samajwadi making statements which have been trying to deflect the agenda. Most of our campaign speeches are still restricted as far as governance is concerned.
Now, how do you see this election progressing? Are we going to see these personal attacks worsen in days and weeks to come?
I think it's an election which has a dual sentiment behind it. There's a huge anti-incumbency against the UPA. It's coupled with a hope as far as the NDA and Narendra Modi are concerned. As the election progresses further, I think the front runner's advantage gets larger.
Well, Arun Jaitley, thanks very much. We're going into that debate next on the News Hour. Arun Jaitley from Amritsar. Thanks.